But you got to get the circling out of your mind so you can get into working on Archie. So now that we have practiced that, we can put most of our mind on Archie. Why do we want to start with Archie? Because he's popular. We're going to let the kids who wear chains stay where they are. In the T, you know, that classroom T where the front, there's the kids in the front row and the kids in the middle row all get the A's. They've done research on that. And then your chain gang kids are here and here. And that reverses in this method. I found that sometimes the little kids who want to memorize is sitting ready to go at the beginning of the year in the front row are going like, you know, it's not the part of the brain they're used to working in, so they have a lot of adjusting to do. But it's amazing how some of these kids with tats, covered with tats, whatever, they're kind of just ticking you out. Let them check you out for a couple of days. Work with the popular kid. Archie's the football player. You got a whole bag of balls and everything here, but let's go with Archie, because Archie's the guy that showed you he needs work. Now, circling with balls is a physical thing where you can just basically take the football and you manipulate Archie. So let's just try that. Now, the guy on the bench is gone. I'm going to try to, you know, we're not going to use that sentence, because now circling with balls, I don't have it with me, but it's a little card, and basically it's a card, anything, piece of paper, doesn't matter. It can be a little card that where they write their name, and I'm looking at it, it says Archie, and there's this line, and then up to the side, it's he drew a picture of a football, you know? And so me and Archie are going to be talking about that, and the class is going to watch that. And it may go an hour, it may go an entire class, it may go an entire couple classes. It depends on how Archie comes through for you. Because remember, we're not working on anything but personalizing. That's why we get at the circling viscerally out of the way, so we can work on personalizing. Because what is personalization? It's classroom discipline. It's breaking down resistant kids, and watch how I do this with the football. Class, you know, joue au football américain. Can't say joue au football. You got in French, you got to say joue au football américain. Again, I could write it down on the board if I need to establish meaning, gesture, you know. And now this is the thing about circling. I've had a lot of questions about circling with balls. It's the physical existence of the sports ball there that Archie wants it. Archie wants the ball, and you have it. It's pretty primitive, really. It's about power. And I'm going to be the one to bestow the power. Bestow the football. And that's the kind of thing that a lot of people don't get about circling with balls. It's using the physical ball to establish power over kids. Okay, so class, Archie joue au football américain. Oh. Okay, there's a guy named Seth over here. Seth didn't go for that. What did I say in the last video? If a kid, here's Seth's deal. Oh no. No. We're not working this hard on learning how to do comprehension-based instruction in our language classes to let Seth sit there with his desk, head on his desk. Now Seth needs a little TLC and he wants us to talk about what's on his thing. Tennis, okay. Oh, but he's not as strong and big as... But we'll get to him. These are the kids we need to start circling with balls with. I got a tennis ball here. Just give me a couple days. I'm going to be talking to Archie for a while. Class. Archie. Joue. This is the first week of school, level one. Got to go slow. Hello. And don't give them French names. Claude, Etienne. They go like, now I got to process something about, I don't even know what Etienne is. Stephen, right? Archie, and you know, just say Archie in English. Because Archie, who, first week, let it sink in, plays au football américain. Class. Archie joue au football américain? Oui, class. Archie joue au football américain. That's the end of visceral one. Let's go to visceral two. Now Archie's interested. Now. He wants the ball. He doesn't even know he wants the ball. This, the day before, has become, and you know, he's 13 years old, 14. He's going, I want that football. I want everybody to know that I play football. Well, the fact that he weighs 270 pounds and he's 13 years old is a little giveaway on that, but hey. Okay, so. Remember, I got the power here. He's sitting up. He's paying attention. I broke him down on the day before because I paid attention to him. I stopped the class. I made sure he understood. So, watch the visceral part of this. Now, we just did the first part, visceral one. Here's visceral two. Class. Archie joue au football américain ou au tennis? Well, I'm making direct eye contact with Seth. I'm waiting. His head is still kind of down. I'm going, Seth, tennis ball. Seth, Archie joue au football américain ou au tennis? So I'm establishing a contact with my man Seth, because Seth is next, he knows. Now he's going to be up a little bit. He knows something's going on with him in tennis. See, now, because we have the visceral circling, we don't have to think about that. Now we can personalize, focus on the kids. So this visceral two, class. Archie joue au football américain ou au tennis? We'll get to you later, is the implication. Archie, class, Archie joue au football américain. Correct. Très bien, class. Archie joue au tennis? Non, class. Archie ne joue pas au tennis. Archie joue au football américain. N'est-ce pas? N'est-ce pas? I'm going to move back so we go like this with Archie. You can see this. Archie joue au football. Get it back. I'm going to stop this tape and get one of my kids down here and get the camera moving so you can see this whole thing about how we control kids with circling with balls.